Hello student, now today in this session of business studies class 12 we will be going to discuss one more important concept related with the organizing. When we are talking about the organizing and the structure of the organization, there are two different structures which can be followed in organization. So today we will be discussing about the functional structure of the organization and its merits and demerits. So what is functional organization structure? Functional organization structure is that structure which is based on the various functions which are being performed in the organization. Okay. So this is the structure which is based on the various functions which are being performed in the organization. And when we are talking about the various functions which are being performed in the organization, those type of functions are being grouped under one particular category. So let us say this thing, that there are different types of activities which are related with the production. So that will go in production department. There are different types of activities which are related with sales. So that will go in sales department. Different activities related with the marketing of the goods. So that will go in the marketing department. Okay. Different activities related with the purchase of material. So all the activities will be going in the purchase department. So there are different departments which are being created according to the various functions which are being done in the organization. And then these departments may be subdivided also according to the various activities which are to be performed in each and every department. So this is the basic structure of the functional organization structure. The structure which is depending on the various activities or the functions which are being performed in the organization. Now what are the merits of this functional organization structure? Iske fayde kya hai? The first merit we can say that it is following the system. System in place of chaos and confusion. Because when there is a activities of the same nature or the homogeneous nature activities are being grouped under one department, and all the activities of that particular nature are being done in that particular department only. So each and every department will function in a very smooth manner. So there will be no chaos, there will be no misunderstanding, and there will be no wastage of the resources also. And in the absence of this, there will be a complete wastage of the human efforts and all the other resources. Because when there are number of activities which are being done in the organization, but those activities are not being grouped together of the similar nature in one particular department, then it becomes very complicated and the smooth functioning will not take place. Then comes, when we are talking about the advantages, so the advantages again that is related with the supervision. It is becoming very easy to supervise all the activities because all the activities of the homogeneous nature are coming under one particular group or a department. So when we have to supervise the activity, it becomes very easy for the person to supervise the activity of a particular department. And the person who is taking care of all these things, who is looking after this particular department, he become expert in that field. And he is the person who can supervise each and every activity in the proper manner. So supervision becomes easy. Then comes coordination. There is a better coordination among the employees in the department. Because the employees know this thing, that which type of work is to be done by which person. So the right type of work is given to the right type of person. So there is a better coordination which is taking place within the department. So the departmental activities are completed in the successful manner. Then comes, it also provides us the economy. How the economy is being provided, because when the work is being done of a particular nature by the employee again and again, he become the specialist in that field, wo specialist ban jate hain, and when this specialization takes place, so there is the work which is being done in the proper manner, and when the work is being done in the proper manner without wasting the resources, then what will happen? So we will get the various types of economies in the production or in the scale of production. Okay, then comes the development of the human being. The human beings are developed in a proper manner, because the human beings, or let's say the employees who are working in the department, they get the opportunity to work at the various different types of activities in the concerned department, and when they become expertise in doing all those activity, ultimately it develop that particular employee, and then they become more and more creative and come up with the new and innovative ideas of doing the work. So these were some of the merits which were related with the functional organization structure. Now we come to some of the demerits of this structure. There are some demerits also. When we are talking about demerits, there is a lack of understanding among the different departments. The departments, they are purely concentrating on their activities only, and they are not bothered about the other departments. So this shows that there is a lack of understanding between the department. Let's say, for an example, if the sales department, they want to increase the sale of the product, on the other hand, it has to be seen that the goods should be produced in such number of quantities so that it can be sold. Sales department is doing all the effort and they want to increase the sale, so they are doing their efforts on their own, but without asking the other department also that whether they will be helping them in increasing the sale of the product by producing more goods, or the marketing department will help them in selling the product by making the proper marketing or doing the proper marketing of that product. So this type of understanding is not there. Then departmental conflicts are taking place. There are departmental conflicts which are taking place. When we are talking about the departmental conflicts, so if there is any deficiency on the part of any particular department, so the department, they easily put that deficiency on some other department. So this type of conflicts are taking place, and the failure of one department is easily put or blamed on the other department. And when this type of things are taking place, so the smooth functioning of the organization will not take place. The decision making is also very slow process, because when we have to take some decision in a coordinated manner, we are not able to take those decisions in the coordinated manner, because we are not coordinating with each other. So when this type of decisions are being taken by individual departments, they take the decision very slowly, they do not want to take any risk, they are afraid of this thing that if something goes wrong, they will be held responsible for this thing. So there is a delay in making the various types of decision. Then come limited growth or expansion opportunities. There is a limited growth and expansion opportunity in this form of organization structure, because when we have to do the growth and the expansion of the work, or when the organization want to produce any other allied product, then it becomes very difficult for them to do this thing. For this, they have to set up a new department, because the person who are working in the old department or already established department, they may resist this thing, they may not want to take this liability, or they may not want to take this opportunity to work for something else or to work for some new product. So this type of things are not taking place, so there is a limited scope of growth and expansion in this form of organization structure. So these are some of the merits and the demerits which we have discussed today in the functional organization structure. So on the basis of this thing, it can be said that functional organization structure is suitable for those type of business organization which are doing their business on a medium or the large size स्केल, जो मीडियम साइज स्केल में रहते हैं या जो लार्ज साइज स्केल में अपना बिजनेस करते हैं, दिस फॉर्म ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन स्ट्रक्चर इज सूटेबल फॉर देम ओनली बिकॉज देयर आर नंबर ऑफ एक्टिविटीज विच आर बीइंग परफॉर्म इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड एज द बिजनेस ग्रो एंड एज द बिजनेस ग्रो इन साइज मोर एंड मोर द स्केल ऑफ बिजनेस इज देयर सो द एक्टिविटीज विल ऑल्सो बिकम मोर इन नंबर सो वी हैव टू ग्रुप दोज एक्टिविटीज टूगेदर in a one particular department so that a department can function in the smooth manner and for that we need the functional organization structure. Okay, so hope these things is are clear to you that what is functional organization structure, what are the merits of this structure and what are the demerits of this structure. Thank you and have a nice day.